Could you describe your brother in one phrase?
Evan Geiselman. Brilliant. Little shit. He's a little shit. I couldn't go surf unless it was with someone till I was like probably like 12 or 13. And Eric would always go surf with me, but that was with anything. Even like, I think we would like camp in the backyard or something, and I couldn't go out there unless Eric was out there too. Like, he was like the adult kind of.
When he was super young, I was, you know, like old enough to kind of get into mischief or whatever, just be kids.
Say when paintball guns came out, and Eric would be on it with his friends, and he's 5 years older than me, so I'm like 10, he's like 15, and you cry when you get hit when you're 10 with a paintball gun. So Eric's like, oh yeah, you want to play? Cool, yeah, let's do it.
We were playing in the woods, and he like tripped on a branch running away. I just caught up to him, and I just point blank just roasted him. And he's just like, no. Super young, crying.
I trip in the dunes. I'm like, okay, wait, like doing the white flag, like surrendering, and they just light me up on the ground. I go to my mom crying. We'll be right back. Eric.
Me.
Eric.
Me.
Musician.
A kook.
A professional golfer.
A chef.
If Evan...
Why did I say a chef? Let's rewind that. All right. A chef.
His eyes, guy who's waiting.
That morning, on the porch, I came over super early because we all knew there was waves. The Jaws contest was running. Somehow the direction was just enough to where pipe was still manageable.
It was pretty bad pipe, but there were some crazy waves coming in. And that's kind of always the time that I'm like, whoa, I'm out there, like this is sick, I'm gonna try to go get a good one.
Basically walks out of the reef house with his cup of coffee and two corners come in. And they blow their guts out, two lefts. He's like, sips his cup of coffee and just thinking nothing of it. Oh, we're out there, boys. We're blowing it. We need to be out there.
The thing that's so weird about that whole situation, the only reason I even paddled out, I watched him get so barreled on a left. And it was like one of those deeper lefts, like off aints and like one of those just deep pipe, shallow, crazy lefts. And that's usually where I sit. It's so weird how it works. The only reason if I didn't see him catch that wave, I wouldn't have went out. From his point of view, he said he saw me pull in, and he said he usually kind of looks to see if I was coming up, and then he didn't see me come up, and he's like, okay, shit, he's gonna come up after this next wave, and then I really didn't come up, and I guess he just started gunning it for me. And I think if it was anyone else but him, like it wasn't a bodyboarder, but probably even if it was a different bodyboarder, I definitely probably wouldn't have made it through that situation.
And the weirdest part to me was like my conscience talked to me like, hey, what if your brother got hurt or like drowned today? But I'm like, I was blocking it out. I was like, no, he's skilled, he's smart, he's not gonna do anything stupid, whatever. But like, I definitely had that weird feeling. There's a weird feeling to that whole morning. Xander calls me right away and I answered it. Luckily I did. And he goes, hey, I don't know if you're on the beach, but your brother just got hurt. Get down here quick. And I'm like, fuck. I bailed my girlfriend, I didn't even tell her. I just ran, bolted. By that point, he was on the stretcher. Go over and he's just like, he's conscious, but you could just tell. He's like, he looked like he was just like struggling super hard. For me, seeing it happen to him, like I felt like looking back on it, it was, he did it out of sort of ego. Like, not that he doesn't have the capability, but it just wasn't thought out. I mean, I'm not him, but that's just kind of what I looked at, like adding it all together. And it was just kind of, everything was fast forward, like from his judgment. Like, he didn't really think about, he just ran off, I guess, instinct and adrenaline, everything, you know. It's just, and I mean, thank God, because I don't know, man, if I didn't have my brother, I'd probably, that would have ruined my life, you know.
I was going out there because I'd never catch waves, so I wanted to try to get a wave and I wanted to get barreled. And yeah, that unfortunate situation happened, but it definitely made me just appreciate just each day more, and like some of like the situations I'm in more, just like hold on to them and like, yeah, cherish a lot of the people around me. And yeah, with everything that's happened, I'm just trying to have as much fun as with events, with trips, with everyday activities, just everything. Like, that's kind of how I've looked at it this whole year. So, yeah, I think I'll approach it more just, yeah, I'll wait for when it's good and just feel comfortable. I'll kind of more go with my gut, because that day I knew I didn't want to go out, but I just did. And I think I'll just listen to my gut more and hopefully get some barrels.
Vem, 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 vem. How good was that shit? That made my whole trip.
She grabbed your leash.
Did she?
Yeah.
That's what happened?
Yeah.
Right, wait, flying. Flirty.
Francais is muy bad. Je voudrais three hamburgers with fromage.
Fromage,
oh, cheeseburger. Sorry. With what? You want fries? Oh, and 20 McNuggets. The chicken, the pollo, or
nuggets?
Yes, please.
Four?
20.
The Mexican?
Yes.
Mexican. Menu?
Uh-huh.
Menu drink?
What do you...